So this is part two of the diffusion screencast with our pure carbon rod reacting with oxygen to make carbon dioxide. Here, however, what we're going to try and find is how long will it take for that carbon rod to disappear? We're going to assume that the boundary layer thickness stays constant. In this case, what we have is that the rate of carbon into the air is going to equal the change of moles of carbon with respect to time. So we found what the initial rate of oxygen diffusion into the boundary layer was, and that equaled negative 2 pi L C D sub A V times this mole fraction of oxygen, 0.21, divided by ln of R2 over R1. However, the rate of carbon into the air is going to be positive 2 pi LC D sub AB 0.21, since the rate of carbon is going into the opposite direction, divided by the logarithm of R2 over R1, now the radii are not staying constant. So R2 is the radius of the carbon rod plus this boundary layer thickness, and R1 is that radius of the carbon rod. And remember, that's going to be changing because that's going to be disappearing. And that's going to equal minus the change with respect to time, the moles of our carbon, which is the density of carbon divided by the molecular weight of carbon times the volume of the carbon rod. So the volume of the rod is just the surface area times the radius. So this is going to equal 2 pi RL, and what's changing is the radius. So if we put this together, we find that this is 2 pi LC D sub AB times 0.21 over the ln of R plus 0.5 divided by R, and this is going to equal negative dr dt rho sub c, the molecular weight of carbon, times 2 pi rl. Let's simplify this, because you can see there are a lot of terms that will drop out, and put all the constants on one side. And let's stop and talk about why that term on the right is negative. And the reason it is the radius is disappearing with time, so it's becoming less, or it's negative. The next thing that I like to do is go ahead and solve for that constant. So this part here is going to equal 1.6 times 10 to the minus 5 centimeters squared per second. Now let's do the integration. We know that at t time equals 0, the radius is going to be 1 centimeter. At our final time, our radius is going to be 0. So let's put this into our integral. So we have 1.6 times 10 to the minus 5, 0 to t final dt equals negative from 1 centimeter to 0 r ln of r plus 0.5 divided by r dr. And when we do this, what we end up with is 1.6 times 10 to the minus fifth centimeters squared per second times time equals 0.315 centimeters squared. So when we solve for time, we end up with almost 20,000 seconds or about 5.5 hours.